I'm Dr. Brandi Coyner, and I'm a mammalogist, which means I'm a scientist that studies mammals. Mammals are warm-blooded animals that have hair, give live birth instead of laying eggs, and produce milk for their young via mammary glands. Some examples of mammals are things we have here, such as the fox and the wild cat, but also things like porcupines and beavers. Here at the Sam Noble Museum, I'm in charge of taking care of our mammal collection. Basically, if you think about it, I'm a librarian, but instead of books, I deal with animal skins and skeletons. Growing up, I always thought I wanted to be a medical doctor. But when I was an undergraduate here at the University of Oklahoma, I took a field biology class and was almost instantly hooked. I started volunteering to do research and started volunteering here at the Sam Noble Museum. Then, when it was time to go to medical school, I decided I'd rather go to grad school, and I became a mammalogist. I really like being outside. As a mammalogist, I'm also a field biologist, which means I go find animals where they live in the wild. We tell people we're doing field work. It's not always easy getting to your field sites, but by going to remote and out-of-the-way places, I've been able to hold animals that have never even seen a person. If you're interested in the world around you, science might be a really good career choice for you too. Even if you're not interested in being a scientist, it's important to understand science, as humans have a huge impact on the world around us. Let's take a look at one of our most important specimens here in the mammal collection. This is a black-footed ferret, and black-footed ferrets have gone extinct from the state of Oklahoma. One of their primary food sources are prairie dogs, and people got rid of prairie dogs because we thought they were bad for cattle ranching. This essentially eliminated the food source for black-footed ferrets. Thanks to conservation efforts, by raising them in captivity and reintroducing them into the wild, their populations in other states are growing. But they haven't returned here in Oklahoma and probably won't. This black-footed ferret is one of only 5 ever collected in the state before they went extinct. And it and the other 4 are our only proof that it ever existed here in the state. Here's a rat that 2 of our scientists found a few years ago. This is the golden vizcacha rat, and it lives in the Andes Mountains of South America. The golden vizcacha rat is a desert rodent just like the Texas kangaroo rat, but it lives in salt flats, an even harsher kind of desert. So when our scientists found the golden vizcacha rat, how did they know it was a new species? Well, they did a morphological study, meaning they measured its skull and the skulls of lots of other species. They analyzed those measurements and realized what they had was in fact a new species. Let me show you how it's done. So that it's easier to see, we're gonna switch to these 2 skulls. This is a mountain lion, and this is a domestic cat. As you can see, both of these skulls are pretty similar. They both have large eye sockets, and they have large canine and cheek teeth. These adaptations tell me that they live a carnivorous lifestyle. In all ways, these skulls are almost identical, except for their size. So let's quantify it. The first measurement I'm gonna do is the total width of the skull, which I'm gonna measure at its widest point. For the mountain lion, that number's 345. That's in millimeters, which is what I'm gonna use today. On the domestic cat, that number's gonna be much smaller, and it is at only 283.8. Second measurement I'm gonna take is the length of the tooth row. And on a skull, that's the measurement from the front of the canine to the very back of the last cheek tooth. We have 287.9. And on my domestic cat, we only get 248.7. Now we just did 2 measurements on 2 skulls. When scientists discovered the golden vizcacha rat, they did 19 measurements on 147 skulls held in 8 different mammal collections. But they didn't do their science any different than we did. They just had a much larger data set. Thank you for visiting us behind the scenes in the mammal collection at the Sam Noble Museum.